हेलो एवरीवन, माय नेम इज मुस्कान। आई एम अ लीगल इन द नेटफ्लिक्स क्लिक एंड कंपनी। सो द टॉपिक ऑफ डिस्कशन इज हाउ कैन लिटिगेंट्स लिस्ट देयर केसेस ऑनलाइन। सो लेट्स प्रोसीड विद आवर टॉपिक। ड्यू टू कोविड-19, द सिस्टम हैज बिकम स्टेगनेंट, लीडिंग टू क्लोजर ऑफ कोर्ट्स एंड अर्जेंट केसेस रिमेनिंग अनलिस्टेड। दस टू एनकरेज पेपरलेस फाइलिंग्स एंड इंट्रोड्यूस कॉस्ट सेविंग एफिशिएंसीज, द सुप्रीम कोर्ट अप्रूव्ड फाइलिंग ऑफ द पिटीशंस बाय एडवोकेट्स ऑन रिकॉर्ड, दैट इज AOR, and hearing the cases through the Cisco WebEx application during the lockdown in country due to ongoing pandemic. The last year, the Chief Justice Bob introduced an electronic filing manual developed by the Supreme Council of Electronic Court for online case filing in a webinar hosted by Chief Justice Bob. During the webinar, the Chief Justice stated that the transition to digitalization would not be easy, but it will remain the same for now, and this is the only way to do justice in the country. The user manual launched at the webinar is a step-by-step guide to enable electronic filing, reduce paper consumption, and improve electronic registration. Not all documents with digital signatures are uploaded to the registration portal. This manual explains in detail how to create a digital signature and use it for filing purposes. There are two ways to digitally sign affirmations: a formal statement by the parties involved in the litigation in the petition. One way to sign is by using a digital signature token provided by certified authority approved by Information Technology Act 2000. Another option to sign the document is to use the electronic signature facility. This service is provided by the Indian government, operated exclusively by CDSE. This electronic signature service is provided free of charge, especially for litigants and lawyers who do not have digital signature tokens or cannot pay for such signature tokens. Based on the manual prescribed by Supreme Court, the Delhi High Court has specifically listed the manner in which case can be mentioned. Similarly, different courts have different methods are prescribed on their websites. Procedure for filing urgent matters in a virtual courtroom. Procedure of mentioning various courts have set timings for mentioning. For example, Delhi High Court has changed timings to mention urgent matter to 9 a.m. to 10:30 a.m. from 10:30 a.m. to 12 p.m. on all working days. The applicant is required to prepare a document not exceeding one page explaining the urgency. This document has to be uploaded in PDF format and its size must not exceed 5 MB. For listing the matter before the Delhi High Court, the applicant must access the link and fill in the party's name, category of the case, name, mail ID, contact number of counsel for petitioner, plaintiff, whether the matter is fresh or pending, and upload the document explaining the urgency. If the formalities are completed, an SMS indicating the receipt will be received on the phone number submitted on the link. In case the requested matter is declined, the counsel will receive an SMS on the mobile number submitted by them on the link informing them what the request has been declined. That the request has been declined. There will be an option to request a designated honorable judge for reconsideration by 3 p.m. on the same day itself. If mentioning is allowed, the counsel will receive an SMS informing the acceptance of the matter for urgent listing. A reference number and date of acceptance will be requested, along with direction to fax advance service on the opposite party counsel through email and over mobile. Furthermore, the contact information and email IDs of the government will be provided for effecting advance service. The pleadings have to be submitted within 2 hours of the receipt of SMS on the given email ID. Details of AOGs to be contacted for further follow-up will also be given. The whole set of pleadings have to be served upon the opposite party through email and over mobile. Proof of advance service containing email IDs and contact number of opposite party must be attached as an annexure to the pleadings. The applicant then has to mail the entire set of pleadings, a list of advocates for petitioners, a list of advocates for the respondent, and contact details to the email address given for this purpose. Procedure of listing. If there are any defects in the matter pleadings, an SMS will be sent on the mobile number submitted by the counsel informing the defects, a request to clear defect, and the time within which defects have to be cleared. The matter will be listed only after the defects are cleared. If there are no defects, SMS informing the diary number, case number, and tentative date of hearing will be sent to the counsel. A day before the hearing, court master will call on the mobile number of the counsel, confirming the email IDs of counsels appearing for the matter. After that, court master will send the link for the video conference. Date and time of hearing, meeting number and password and I calendar filed. Automatically adding the event to the council's calendar. Procedure for hearing. First, download the application called Cisco WebEx Meeting from and log in by entering the name and email ID. Click on the join meeting button in the link sent to the mail ID by the registrar. Some minutes before the meeting, court master will inform the councils over the call that the next item is of them and the meeting is about to start. Finally, the bench introduces all the councils and proceedings start. Requisites of pleading. File must be in PDF format. Scanned soft copy has to be uploaded. Application with the prayer for exemption from filing duty, affirmed affidavits and undertaking to pay the court fees, deficit court fees within 72 hours from the date of assumption of the regular functioning of the court. Filing of proof of service is mandatory and must be marked as the last annexure. The party and counsel should sign pleadings and applications. The entire set of pleading, including affidavits, annexure, applications, and last annexure proof of service, should be sent as one file. It is important to note that the pleading must be kept ready before submitting the request for urgent listing. Once the request is allowed, the council must mandatorily mail the entire set of pleadings within 2 hours of receipt of accepting SMS conclusion. So, conclusion. For COVID-19, due to the partial shutdown of the court, the system has become stagnant and emergency cases have not been resolved. Therefore, in unresolved urgent cases, the court decided to submit cases electronically in a virtual model. The initiative was adopted by Supreme Court of India, which allows advocates on record to submit cases electronically because it saves paper and times and prevents the spread of COVID-19. It is also a profitable method because it does not use paper and urgent cases can be easily filed from anywhere, saving the litigants time, and hence the time to list cases is less than before. Therefore, electronic filing plays an important role in continuing judicial work without harming the spread of virus effectively and inexpensively. So that's all for today. If you like my video, do like, comment and subscribe to the Lex Click YouTube channel. Thank you.